two-fan air coupler and how it relates to a torque converter. When the speed of the rear fan or drive fan, which represents the impeller, is limited, the front fan remains stationary. The air force is not great enough to drive the front fan, which represents the turbine. As the speed of the drive fan increases, the air force also increases and the front driven fan starts to rotate. A strobe light is used to make it appear as if the front driven fan is not moving. This is done to show that the two fans do not turn at the same speed. The front fan is turning at approximately 10% slower. This is an air coupler. In the torque converter, hydraulic fluid is used instead of air. Because the driven front fan is not mechanically connected, I can reach in and stop the front fan with my hand. The resistance to flow of air can be heard from the sound created by the fan. With my hand, I can feel the force or torque that is being applied to the driven front fan. In the torque converter, hydraulic fluid is used instead of air, and the fluid is reused. In other words, after the fluid force strikes the outer vanes on the turbine, the fluid travels around the guide ring and returns back into the center vanes on the impeller. This is a fluid coupler, and eventually the returning fluid striking the impeller will place a load on the impeller, making it more difficult to rotate. Enter the stator, which solves this problem and causes a multiplication in torque upon the turbine. The stator directional vanes and one-way clutch will redirect the fluid that is returning into the impeller. The fluid entering the impeller center vanes now strikes the vanes at an angle that promotes impeller rotation, much like a tailwind when flying makes it easier for the airplane to go faster. The stator one-way clutch is locked and prevents the rotation of the stator vanes. This happens whenever the rotational speed of the turbine is less than approximately 90% of the rotational speed of the impeller. This is also known as torque converter speed ratio. A 0% speed ratio would mean the turbine is stationary while the impeller is rotating. The lower the speed ratio, the greater the torque multiplication. Fluid directional flow back and forth between the impeller and turbine is known as vortex fluid flow. Speed ratio, impeller speed, vortex flow, and torque multiplication are all related proportionally. Once the speed ratio becomes approximately 90% and greater, the stator one-way clutch unlocks and begins to free spin. The torque converter is now in fluid coupler mode as compared to torque mode when the stator was locked. Torque converter, lock up fluid control. It's important to note that this is a generic example of how the lockup torque converter fluid flows in a non-electronically controlled torque converter. During converter operation, when the torque converter is not in lockup mode, pressurized fluid enters the relay valve at port 1 and exits port 2. The fluid enters the converter between the front cover and the lockup piston, which prevents lockup. Fluid will exit the converter and return to the relay valve into port 3 and out to passageway 4, which goes to the oil cooler. When the signal valve receives pressurized fluid from the speed sensor to lock the converter, the signal valve moves upwards. This opens fluid passageway number 6 to pressurized fluid, which enters the relay valve at port 7. This pressure will move the relay valve up. Moving the relay valve to a new position changes the direction of fluid flow into and out of the converter. Fluid now flows in port 1 and out port 3, where it enters the converter between the impeller and the turbine. The fluid continues through the converter where it can force the lockup piston against the converter front cover. The fluid continues to port 2 on the relay valve and out port 5 to the oil pan. This locks the front cover to the turbine via the lockup piston.